Yeah, Martha, and I've spoken with several runners who say that minutes after the explosions, they had no way of getting to their family or friends. Cell phone service was down immediately after the race, once the race was stopped, and the only way to really get in touch with one another was through social media. Orlando runner Heather Scholes had reason to celebrate as she crossed the finish line at the Boston Marathon.
2:59.52. It was my first time breaking 3 here, so I was really excited, yeah.
She immediately posted her race results on Facebook. Then, moments later, everything changed.
I had just posted how excited I was, you know, to have broken 3 hours, and it was so awesome, and I was on cloud 9, and then the next thing you know, I'm having to post that my family, that me and my family are safe and, you know, that everybody was okay.
With cell phone service down,
they were calling and it wasn't coming through. It was just going straight to voicemail.
Runners and their families turned to social media.
I'm not like a big Facebook person, but Facebook kind of saved the situation for us. So I just put on Facebook, we're okay, no communications.
One minute you're, you know, so happy and you're waiting to hear from all your friends how they did, and then you're just wanting to make sure they're alive and okay.
And you're looking live at Boylston Street right now. This part of the street is still closed. Over there you can see the finish line of the Boston Marathon. That's where the runners would be coming toward us to finish the race. The Boston Public Library there is on the left. This is still considered a crime scene, so we don't expect this to open up anytime soon. However, some of the blocks here on Boylston Street have opened as the day has progressed. Coming up at 6 p.m., we're going to hear more from some local runners, including John and Betsy Hughes, who many people know as the owners of Track Shack in Orlando. Live in Boston, Aixa Diaz, WESH 2 News.